Well, as we mentioned earlier, a new book looking back on the history of the governance of Samoa was released this week. Author Dr Peter Swain is no stranger to the Pacific, having spent three decades managing development programs for international organisations in the islands. He co-authored the biography of former Samoa Prime Minister Tuilaepa Sa'ilele Malielengoi, and he joins us now for our Talanoa. Thank you for joining us on the show, Dr Swain.
Thank you.
Wow, whānau the contest for the governance of Samoa. What prompted you to write this book?
Well, when we had worked through Palamea, people came up to me and said, oh, I'd forgotten about that. I can't remember that happening, or I didn't know of these things. And so what I realised, there was actually a wider history that needed to be told. And so I started researching the story of Samoan politics, of a governance, from first settlement right up until this next general election in 2021.
And I think maybe some people watching at home may be asking or thinking, what makes you qualified to write this book?
Well, when I got married, my wife, Lorna Vale, said to me, you don't only marry me, you marry my family, you marry my village, and you marry my country. So there was no option for
no
me.
No option. Now, I understand that it's been a couple of years in the making for this book.
Yes.
Tell us about it. You originally wanted to call it a parliament, whānau a parliament of chiefs.
Yes. Well, things have changed in the last number of years. Samoa has gone through the period of political stability for nearly 30 years, from Tofio Aoiti Alasana through to Tulaepa. But the world changed in 2021 with the general election. So when I looked at the history, there's been a contest for the governance of Samoa right from the early days through the German period, through the New Zealand period, and right up today. So that seemed to me the theme. There was a contest, and now the contest has been rejoined.
How incredible was that as you're writing this book on the Samoa political history and then to be seeing the dramatic events of last year right before your eyes happening?
Well, when you're writing a book, you think, oh, well, I've just about got cracked now. But then things changed and I had to rewrite one chapter about five times because it kept evolving. And it's still evolving. This is a story that hasn't ended.
You know, in terms of the political landscape in Samoa, if we look, for example, at the issue of head of state, can you tell us what you see for the future of the head of state in terms of what we saw happen last year in terms of the questioning of the authority of the head of state?
Well, government is about a balance between the judiciary, the executive, and the parliament. That balance got upset during this election, where judicial decisions were involved in a number of matters, including challenging the role of the head of state. So I think there's a period of settling down that will happen in the next period. And at the end of the day, the Samoans sorted it out themselves. They got a resolution, things have moved on. But there'll need to be some changes over time as this evolves. So it's an ongoing story, I believe.
When you look at the governance of Samoa, how do you think it differs compared to other Pacific countries?
One of the fundamental things of the governance of Samoa, it's based on village whānau. So the whamātai and the whasamoa are at the heart of that. And so one of the important parts of the whasamoa is a talanoa between chiefs. And that conversation is a way of working through problems and issues and concerns. And I think that's one of the gifts that Samoa has in terms of that chiefly conversation. So rather than rushing to a legal outcome or a legal intervention, having that talanoanga amongst the chiefs is a good way of resolving these problems. And I think we'll see that develop because that's at the heart of Samoan governance.
Well, thank you very much for your time. I look forward to reading the book in a little more detail, especially the rich history that is in here as well. Whawhtai lava.
Whawhtai fui.